up. Here's my thoughts on lust. I recently asked a question to my platform of Instagram followers if I should start OnlyFans to share more of the natural content, meaning uncensored, because I like to be in my natural state outside, in nature, and many are saying that I should do it. Many are saying, many are still saying that I shouldn't. Both sides, right? And the good reason to, you know, share it, and the only reason people do it, OnlyFans, is to make profit. That's it, right? They do it to make money, and a lot of people are making a lot of money off of it, and they're supporting their lifestyles through just sharing that. But it's just all pure lust, right? It's pornography. And that act has an energy, a frequency that is very low. So the ones that are partaking within it, they are not in the higher realms. Significant other, to your partner, to the one that you love. You are not lusting over their physical 3D body, because true love is a connection with the spirit, a connection with the soul, with the metaphysical. It's so much more than just our physical vessel. But within lust, in the 3D, is when it's kind of grotesque to think that we even can view each other in these ways. It's not godly. And that's what this journey has been about, is returning to godliness, remembering our godly, remembering that we are gods, and gods do not partake in those frequencies, and that would be a demon. Those are demonic pleasures, desires that only pull us down and keep us from transcending and rising up. Even if one, as a man, is practicing semen retention, if one is still taking involvement in lustful actions, that one is still going to be pulled down into the lower dimensions. You cannot not be in heaven being a lust puppy, being a dog, drooling for the pleasures of, you know, the woman's body. And vice versa, it goes, you know, same for the woman, you know, perceiving the man as just a sexual toy. It's just a frequency, it's an energy, and it's actually, it's a non-existing form of energy, non-existing form of consciousness, nor awareness. It's acting out of the lower chakras. Our heaven state is up here, in the crown, and above, in the astral. But if we're just staying, if we're just in lust, we're also going to be in food, lust, it's food, sex, sleep, the lower chakras, the root chakra. That is hell. We need to free ourselves from these desires and align all the chakras to be able to live in this beautiful heaven that we are existing in, or that is existing here within us and around us. But there are things keeping us from connecting to our higher states, our higher forms of consciousness, our godliness. One of the biggest things keeping us from raising our consciousness is the food that we consume, or just, it's everything that we consume. Now, many things are put here to keep us from raising our consciousness, like these processed foods and these programmings through the television and so many more things. But the food, or the non-food that they are feeding us, that we've been programmed to think we need and are just so addicting and so desirable, these foods wreak havoc on not just our body, but our spirit, energetically, metaphysically. As I sit here and talk about this, I'm looking in the distance at this beautiful duck in the middle of the canal, bathing and shaking its feathers. And you see it's the cutest, most beautiful thing ever. That's beauty right there. Us lusting after each other is not beauty. It's the rape culture. It's objectifying each other. This is living or non-living, existing in the lower realms of consciousness. Some beautiful oranges right here, some local Florida oranges, some of the juiciest, best oranges I've ever tasted in my life. There's a whole wall of bamboo over here singing from the wind, palm trees, this beautiful canal that is connected to the aquifer that is glowing with this vitality of the pure living water here that I bathe in every single day, because it's not just about cleansing the outside, it's about cleansing the whole aura energetically. It's a whole bath, it's a whole cleanse that leaves me feeling amazing every time I touch that water. That's one of the natural things that, you know, spike our dopamine, make us feel happier without a negative effect, you know, like processed. processed foods and dead foods. They spike our dopamine like heroin, hundreds of times. And then they bring us, when we come back down, we crash really hard and we feel worse than we ever did before even consuming it. And it's this constant cyclic cycle of just up and down, up and down. It's the roller coaster of feelings. Or not actually feeling. And it's just running off of emotions versus having the discipline to just, we just need to connect back with source. We've been unplugged. We gotta unplug from the matrix, from the programming, and plug back into divinity. Plug back into source. Plug back into nature, because we are nature. Without it, we are not, we cannot exist. We gotta free ourselves from everything that's been demolished. I was gonna say created, but it's been, so much of us have been just absolutely demolished. And the last thing they want us to do is remember what we are. Remember our power. Just one of us can spark, you know, it's just like one of us. It's all it takes is one to infect the rest, to inspire and start a revolution. Very easily seen. Oh man, there's these three ducks right now flying down the river. Oh, I think they're out. Oh, they just landed. One landed. Oh, there's two more still flying. Oh, and they landed. So beautiful. I wish you guys could have seen that. It's so beautiful to see. Just, they come in. That's beautiful. Cleaning the other one. This is the things that most of us don't even see on our daily basis. We're so locked in and imprisoned within the programming, the matrix of wake up, shower, eat a dead breakfast, brush the teeth with chemicals, put the chemical shampoos, conditioners on, perfumes, laundry detergent, clothes, candles within the house, air fresheners within the car, driving on the highway of depression, just so far from nature. We need to get back to this fruit of life. The living foods. Because we're living beings, the light beings, we are light beings, we are gods, we just have to remember it. Everything, all of this is a freaking manifestation of God. We need to get out in the sun. We're fearing the sun. They've made us fear the freaking energy source. We need to get back to climates that support our beings. We are not designed to be in cold climates. This is why people eat so far from the diet, our species-specific diet. It's because we are in these climates that do not support our species-specific diet, our way of living. And this is why we are dying at early ages and consuming things that don't meet our needs. any of us are here. We're here to remind and guide each other back home. Back to nature. Back to abundance. Back to beauty. When I was on the dead foods, I couldn't even see beauty anywhere. Right now, the colors are like popping with green, turquoise, and the flowers, and everything's just like, it's like I feel like I'm tripping on life. My brain is activating as it should be. And but on the dead foods, the dead things, we cannot see clearly. We cannot. We just don't. It's, we have a lack of awareness. Wow, this is a bird. I don't know if you can see it. Wow, I think it's a hawk. So beautiful. Can you see this? I don't know if you see it, but. Beauty is in the eye of the beholder. But yes, this is what we're here to do, remind each other, bring each other back home. I'm very grateful to be here. It's not always easy for sure, considering going against the programming brings, you know, difficulties because I trigger the programming, but I'd rather have it hard than easy, you know? It's just so much more fulfilling to see the effect that one can have when somebody sends the message saying, you know, how much that helped them. Just seeing the light within others, it brings pure joy, pure fulfillment. Something that's lasting, something that's real, not something that's, you know, just fake, like material things, and lustful relationships. And, you know, when you wake up, you really start to feel people's intent very quickly, and you see everyone for who they are, including yourself. I still have so much darkness I'm dealing with in myself. It's not just wake up and everything's, you know, bright and shiny. It takes time to unwrite and undo these things that were so well distilled in us. Find my two biggest difficulties, or the two things that I'm working on most that were so programmed into me. Food, sex. Those two things right there are my main things, the main programs that I'm unwriting. Food, I was always the overeater, the overconsumer, because it was kind of awarded if I was to consume as much as my family. If I can consume as much as them, it was like an award, like, good job, like, you know, it was like reinforced. And then for sex, you know, I had the access to pornography the age of, I don't know, 11, around that age. I mean, look at all the cartoons they fed us. When you wake up and realize what all these cartoons' messages have written within them, a lot of it's based off of pedophilia, and they want us to, you know, feel that lust and sex is okay. And there's a lot of programming within the cartoons that show this. And it's very demonic. But I'm grateful that I'm aware. I feel whenever my energy shifts towards, you know, the darkness, and I get self-realization through it all. It's like it's every single day moment is a lesson to learn from. And yeah, I'm not perfect, but that is perfect, you know? What is perfection? Perfection for me is just focusing on progressing with the most noble intent. What are your intentions? What do you really want? What are your desires? I mean, I don't feel as it's healthy to desire, but if there's something to desire, it's a higher form of consciousness. Desire to be in the godly form where I don't need anything, because gods don't need anything. We've only been taught that we need things. We don't need anything. Everything's here. The air, the water, the sun, ground, the soil, the earth, the elements. Once we can return closer to our godly remembrance, then we can absorb the subtle energies, the subtle foods. It's beginning to rain right now. This is beautiful. Little sprinkles. That's why I love the tropics. It's so like, it's changing, ever changing so fast. One second it's sunny, the next second it's raining. There's these huge clouds. There's fish jumping out of the water right now. I saw some turtles. I found a coconut on my bike ride today. I got sapodillas in my bag. I was eating sapodilla, which is a little fruit. It's like a brown sugar fruit. I was eating that off the ground today. Nature provides. We just gotta get out of this fear frequency that they've put us into and get back into abundance and just, yeah, just trusting in everything. That's all I got to say for today. I'm gonna enjoy some more oranges here. Probably get back on my bike and go for a bike ride back home. Which I never left home. I'm here. I'm here at home. Everywhere is home. Everywhere I take a breath is home. But if this resonated with you in any way, appreciate it. Thank you for listening and being here. And yeah, God bless for whatever that means for you. Bliss and blessings.